367 days ago, Joe Douglas traded Jamal Adams to the Seattle Seahawks, and the Seattle Seahawks are already regretting it. Hey, what's going on? I'm Matt O'Leary, back with another video. Today we'll be talking about Jamal Adams and his contract negotiations not going too well, and the Jamal Adams trade a year ago. But before we get started today, I just wanted to mention you can follow me on social media at Matt O'Leary NY. If you haven't already, please make sure to subscribe to the Just Jets podcast, wherever it is that you get your podcast. And don't forget about the giveaway. We're giving away a Zach Wilson jersey and two packages for Manscaped. All you got to do is subscribe to this channel and the Just Jets Clips channel, which is linked down below in the description. Enter to win, and I'll pull the winners once this hits 10K. So, as I stated at the top of the video, a year ago and 2 days ago, Jamal Adams was traded from the New York Jets. And if you remember, it was a very toxic ending. And Joe Douglas had a player who, well, didn't want to be here anymore. And he made it abundantly clear that he didn't want to be here throughout that entire process. And still, somehow, some way, Joe was able to get not one, but two first-round picks and a third-round pick. So obviously a pretty big haul for a safety, regardless of how good they are. And circumstance, you know, obviously it was a player who was not going to come back and play for the New York Jets. And the Jets were ridiculed by some. Jet fans knew that they couldn't give in to his demands. He wanted $20 million a year. And they said, okay, like that's just absolutely ridiculous. He was trying to hold this franchise over the barrel. And, you know, Jets fans, for a majority of them, was like, okay, this is enough. This is crazy. The Jamal Adams heel turn wasn't exactly something I was expecting, but it was something that happened. But you have a lot of fan bases around the NFL who call the Jets a poverty franchise for trading their best player and this and that. Well, now, a year and 2 days later, who's having the laugh? It came out yesterday that Jamal Adams and the Seattle Seahawks are nowhere close in contract negotiations, which these are just things you hate to see. If you have a list of things you don't want to see and things you hate to see, this is probably towards the top of that. So as I mentioned, notoriously, he asked for $20 million a year. If you look at what their roster is, Bobby Wagner is their highest paid player on the defense at $18 million. I don't think they want to make Jamal Adams the highest paid player on that defense. I think they want it to be Bobby Wagner. So he's probably going to have to take $17 or $17.5 million, which, by the way, would be resetting the safety market by a significant margin, by a lot. Right now, the highest paid safety AAV is Justin Simmons coming out at $15.25 over, you know, the course of the contract, $15.25 per year. $17 or $17.5 million is a tremendous bump. A huge bump, but still, this is a player, a greedy player, asking for $20 million a year. That just doesn't make any sense at all based on what he is. One, the position he plays, safety, and number two, he's not great in coverage. Yes, he's good at getting after the quarterback. Yes, he's good in the box. He's a very, very good player. Is he worth that kind of money, though? I would say probably not, no, and that's why Seattle doesn't want to pay that, but they put themselves in this position a year ago because they gave up so much capital to get this guy, and they still can't find a way to sign him, and now the pressure is on Seattle because you can't give up all that draft capital and then say, ah, you know what, we're going to let you walk out the door after 2 years. It doesn't make any sense. So far, from the Jets' perspective, they got Elijah Vera Tucker out of the deal. They moved up in the first round. They gave up, you know, the third round picks to move up in the draft and get Elijah Vera Tucker. So far, so good. And guess what? They have another first rounder next year. Have no idea where that pick is going to be in 2022 in the first round. But the Jets have draft capital and are building this thing the right way for the most part. Got to have a lot of faith in Joe Douglas. Got to have a lot of faith in Robert Saleh, young quarterback. No headaches at the moment. That's a big thing we've talked about on the Just Jets podcast a ton. The lack of headaches on this Jets team. And could you imagine just the drama of Jamal Adams last year, or when he had those issues over a year ago, and if he was on the team in 2020, how much worse would 2020 have been if Jamal Adams was here and unhappy because he didn't get paid, and then on top of that, they were going 2-14. He would have been miserable. It would have been even more miserable than having to watch it the first time through, going 2-14 without Jamal Adams. So I will absolutely take this trade once again a year later, completely fine with it. Love the value. Love getting Elijah Vera Tucker. And they have another top 30, at worst, top 32 player in the NFL draft going to be coming in here. So something that I'm excited about. And once again, Seattle, you just really hate to see it. I'm sorry to say. It's a crying shame. That's going to do it for me. Quick reaction video today. Just wanted to talk about this news. Training camp got underway this week, so going to be on board with some more stories from that coming up this week in more videos, but just wanted my quick reaction out there on the Jamal Adams story. Let me know in the comments how you feel about it, and on social media at Matt O'Leary NY. Make sure to subscribe if you're new here, and I'll talk to you next time.